This video is for educational purposes only. It is not sponsored, endorsed, or affiliated with any brands or manufacturers featured. All products shown in this video are owned by me. In Chapter 1, Episode 6, we will learn about MCB curve. First, we will understand its characteristics. In Episode 1 and 2, we learned about MCB thermal unit that is responsible for the long-time protection, and we also learned about MCB electromagnetic unit that is responsible for short-time instantaneous protection. These protection units are very important to understand because MCB curve represents thermal and magnetic characteristics. Let's first understand how MCB curve works. The horizontal axis shows current in amperes, and the vertical axis shows time in seconds, so it is the relation between current and time and how the MCB will behave accordingly. The MCB curve has two zones. The first zone is for long-time thermal protection, and the second zone is for short-time instantaneous electromagnetic protection. Miniature circuit breakers have rated current IN that defines long-time thermal trip setting. They also have magnetic trip range, which is minimum and maximum magnetic currents. This range defines short-time instantaneous magnetic settings. Creating this content takes a lot of time, effort, and experience. Support us by subscribing and liking the video. It helps us keep producing free, high-quality information for you and others. And if you have any technical question, feel free to ask us in the description, and we will provide you with the answer. Now we can say if the current is between IN and minimum magnetic settings, the MCB will trip thermally in delayed time. And if the current is between the minimum and maximum magnetic settings, the MCB will trip magnetically in short instantaneous time. Now if the current is before IN setting, the MCB will not trip, and if the current is after maximum magnetic setting, the MCB will trip in short instantaneous time but at risk of fire hazard or damage depending on the intensity of the fault and how much can the MCB handle high intensity faults. In the next episode, we will check the MCB curve variations, and we will do a comparison between them. Also, we will identify curve type from the MCB.